So, we have all this data that tells us all this information about different traits or characteristics of people for whom the data was collected. In our class data set, for example, we have information about how tall you are, about what kinds of insurance you have, and about what your favorite color is. But unless you're a celebrity or under investigation for some reason, it's unlikely that many people outside of your friends and family care to know any of this information about you per se. Usually they want to know this information about the typical person in the population or subpopulation to which you belong. Or they want to know more about the relationships between people who are like you in some way and some outcome that they're interested in. Before we can make any inferences or draw any conclusions using our data, we must, or at least should, begin by conducting descriptive analyses of our variables. This can also be referred to as exploratory analysis. There are at least three reasons why we want to start with descriptive analysis. First, we can use descriptive analysis to uncover errors in our data. Second, it helps us understand the distribution of values in our variables. And third, descriptive analysis serve as a starting point for understanding relationships between our variables. When conducting descriptive analysis, the method you choose will depend on the type of variable you're analyzing. At the most basic level, variables can be described as numerical or categorical. Numeric variables can then be further divided into continuous and discrete, the distinction being whether a variable can take on a continuum of values or only a set of certain values. Categorical variables can be subdivided into ordinal or nominal variables, depending on whether or not the categories can logically be ordered in a meaningful way. Finally, for all types and subtypes of variables, there are both numerical and graphical methods we can use for descriptive analysis. In the videos and exercises that follow, you're introduced to measures of frequency, measures of central tendency, and measures of dispersion. Then you learn various methods for estimating and interpreting these measures using SAS.